Hello traders, so today we are going to review the most commonly used indicator or a charting tool in the trading business, which is called Fibonacci lines. There is a vast number of different Fibonacci methods. Today we are going to review Fibonacci retracement levels, which is the most commonly used method. So if you're trading, if you're using TradingView for your charts, then you only go to the left side menu, and then you can see here you have a fib retracement levels, and then you can actually do the Fibonacci levels chart. So let me show you how do you do. It's extremely simple. So you take here, you take Fibonacci retracement, then you take a high that you want to measure. So more or less what Fibonacci does, it connects two extreme points, usually a peak and a low, a high and a low. And then dividing the vertical distance, so from here, because we are going to measure this here to this low here, it actually divides the vertical distance by the key Fibonacci ratios. So let me show you how you do it. It's very simple. So you just you measure the peak here, and then you go down, and then make sure that zero comes where the low is, and then you have the levels, you have the key levels. The key levels that we are talking about are 2360, 3820, 50%, which is a halfway distance, 6180, 7816, 8860. The most important ones are located here in the middle, so we are talking about 3820, 50 and 61.8 is the major resistance retracement level, and is usually the one that where you see a reaction which is quite strong from that level. So here in this chart we have a pound dollar, we have a Brexit downside move to almost 2,000 pips move, and then we look for a low which happened a couple of months ago, and then we saw retracement. So look what happened. So first of all, you're not looking at this part between the high and the low. You only look at the part which is after the low has been made. So after you connect the low, so the price starts here, this is the low, and then you have a retracement model. So here, look, we retrace here to 23.6. it's a reaction. There we have a reaction. So here it's a first reaction, then we go again, we again fail, we go again, we fail, then once we move above, then then this becomes actually a support. You can see after we clear 23.6, now it's not a resistance, now it's a support, and eventually we come to 38.2. here we come close, here we touched it, and then again we retrace, we move it. This is a choppy trading. We go to the next one. It's a 50%. We clear 50%. We go to 61%. Here, 61% is not really respected. But what I wanted to show you is what is actually respected. It's 78.6. That's usually a common thing in the pound dollar, that you have a big retracement to 78.6. So almost whole move was retraced. You can see here we start at 150, and here we came all the way to 1.44 from 119. So we traveled 2,500 pips to the high here. So in this kind, in this level, we had 23 points. In this chart, we had 23.6 respected. We have 78.6 move respected. So this is how you do it. You connect the high with the low. So this here again is the dollar, is the Aussie dollar chart. Again, we have a high, we have a low, we connect high with the low, and then we have the levels. As you can see here in this chart, 50 is extremely well is respected. You can see here high at 50, down move to 38.2, and then again next move to to 61.8. Why is this chart important? This is one of the most commonly used price actions that you will see. What you see is you see a reaction to one level, which is a 50. You see a move to 38.2, to the level before, which now acts as a support. You see then a move to 61.8, and then you see a move down. Why? Because as I said, the 61.8 is also referred as the golden ratio, level, simply because it is extremely important level in the in any charting that you do. Is actually I know traders who base all their trading plan based on the 61.8 retracement. So here you can see we actually came close. Sometimes it touches, sometimes it goes above, sometimes it's really below, but here we are talking about 10 pips or something. And then after we touch 61.8, then we continue lower and we drop lower. Look what happened here again in the Kiwi dollar. I intentionally used the same chart to draw two Fibonacci levels. So again, we have a peak, we have a major move down. Look what happened here. We have peaks above 38.2, but we did not close. We have a move down. We touched 50. We move down to 38.2, and then of course we have a move well above 61.8. But what happens is we close closer to 50, which immediately pushes the price extremely down. And then we have a big move which creates a new low. And then in the same chart you have a move from the down to the up. And then what I wanted to show you here, so we have a move down, up, and then you have first level here, touch 23.6 retracement, you go up. Next, second one is 38.2, first big retracement level. 23.6 is a first level, usually not really that respected, but 38.2 is the first key level. Big rejection here. We find support, we find buyers, we go create a equal high. Move again down, 38.2, up 38.2 again. We fail to close. You see, we rebounded. We go up before eventually pushing lower. So usually it's very hard, or it's impossible to find a chart that respects every level. But as I said, certain pairs, for example, dollar yen really likes 61.8, pound really likes 78.6, and the last level of retracement that is observed is 88.6. It's not a big level, it's a minor level. As I said, the key levels are here located in the center, 38, 50, 61. 78.6 can also play a major role, but 88.6 is like a last train station for the bulls, because you see here they almost retraced and lost all gains that they gained, but at 88.6 you see a reaction, and then we see a push higher from this level. So Fibonacci again is it's most widely Fibonacci retracements actually that we are reviewing today is one of the most widely used trading tools, mostly because of their relative simplicity and especially to their applicability to any trading instrument. So whatever you trade, Forex, commodities, stocks, cryptos, you can use Fibonacci retracement levels when you're looking for trend moves, when you're looking for retracements. Here, for example, if you think this is a uptrend and if you want to buy, then you look at your 38.2. if you placed your order here, you put your stop loss maybe somewhere in between 50 and 38.2, you will have caught this move. One move, second move, here it will be closer to your stop, but again the third move is caught. So usually I strongly advise, when trading Fibonacci, put your stop loss below the key level, below the levels. So because when they push through like we have here, we usually very quickly go below, so you don't lose more money. But if you want to trade only Fibonacci's, then look at 38.2, 50 and 61.8.